Hey, hello everyone. How are you this wonderful Friday afternoon? Just one second here. I always forget to turn off my notifications. So how is everyone today? This is Elena with Heart for Wellness Coach. How are you doing? Hey, Daniel. I wanted to talk about today, to continue my last conversation last Friday, I wanted to chat about food quality and why it matters. Hey there, thanks for joining me today. You know, when it comes to nutrition and diet, so many people, myself included, put a lot of effort into their meal planning, right? Calorie counting, counting macros, cycling carbs, avoiding sugar. I mean, so many people are really jumping on the wellness bandwagon, and I think it's wonderful. I think it's so great. Nutrition is beginning to become more of a focal point in people's everyday lives, and that's amazing because it really should be, because really we are what we eat, we are what we absorb, right? So we're taking so much care in, you know, what we're eating. Even stressing about it, what to eat, when to eat it, when should I have my protein, you know, those kinds of questions go through our mind as we're planning our meals. But with all that time and effort that goes into our nutrition, one major and very important thing that sometimes that I feel like we miss, and this was me too, is actually the quality of our food. So, you know, nutrition has such a big impact on the health and wellness of every single individual, right? Our lives, as well as those of our family and our friends, everyone in the world, right? We want to really feel our best. So as we go along in this discussion, I think it's going to really help. It's kind of an eye-opener for me as I did my research too. To really dig in and find out exactly where our food is coming from and what really we should be looking for in the grocery store. So we're going to touch on that a little bit today. Sometimes having a high standard and a high quality food means that we're going to pay a little bit more. But you know what? You really are worth it. I know that sometimes it can hit the pocketbook, but there's other ways to compensate. I had a post earlier this week in my Instagram that talked about other ways that we can compensate for our grocery bill, right? So when we're eating high quality foods, like high quality vegetables and fruits, and especially meats, if we can choose to eat less meat during the day, during the week, that can definitely cut back on our grocery bill. But what I really want to focus on today is really what we can do to get better quality food into our diets. You know, we've heard the saying, you know, pay the farmer now or pay the doctor later. It's so true. And I, you know, particularly, I would like to pay my farmer. You know, so many of us now today don't have health insurance. If we do, it's not very good. You know, and so really in the long run, having better quality foods that we can eat during the day, it's really going to help us out in the long run, right? We're not going to have those medical bills because we're sick. We're not going to be going into the doctor every week because there's something wrong with us, right? And then having to pay deductible, having to pay an office visit, and all of those things. So it's really in the long run, it's going to do your body much better. So I want to start off the discussion talking about meats. So for those of us who, you know, most of us eat, you know, meat every single day, right? I cannot stress quality enough here, because there is a huge, huge difference in a highly processed meat, a meat that is fed, an animal that is fed grain, which is not a natural diet for that animal, and an animal that is fed grass from start to finish. There is a big difference in not only the flavor of the meat, the texture of the meat, but also the nutrition of the meat. It is huge. It's a really big difference. Because that animal is getting what it naturally needs. And so when that animal goes to process, we're going to get what we need too. So, what I suggest is to find local farmers. There's someone somewhere, there's a farmer near you that processes their animals, that takes them from grass-fed all through their lives, all the way to grass finish. Support local farmers. Get grass-fed finished beef, organic chicken, heritage breed pork, wild-caught fish. Buy directly from the farmer so you can ask them questions. I actually just did this last week. I have there's a farm locally here to me that was selling organic, free-range, non-GMO boiler chickens, and I got to ask them, okay, how did you raise these chickens? What did they eat during their lifetime, and how did you process them? That is another big question. You want to make sure that your meat is not processed with chemicals, because that is what happens in meat processing plants. Their meats are actually dipped in, sometimes they're dipped in bleach and other chemicals to sanitize them, and that gets packaged and put in the grocery store, and you pick it up and you eat it. So, you really want to make sure that your meat comes from an animal that's fed a diet that's natural to it. Most animals do free range, and if they're free ranging for the majority of their life, that's perfect. You also want to make sure that when you do pick up beef, it says on the package grass finished, because what happens, and I've been around the agriculture of farming community long enough to know and understand this, is about a month before they're ready to process, the farmers will bring them in and they will fatten them up on corn, non-GMO corn. And so what happens is not only did they get a better value for that animal, right? Because it weighs more because of all that fat. But the danger with that is that if they're fed those non-GMO grains, that gets into their fat. And then when you go home and you eat that, then you're getting that toxin into your body as well. So I don't know, a lot of people may not realize that that is what goes on in the industry. So you're getting extra hormones because of that non-GMO corn. You're getting toxins like glyphosate. Other things that they may have sprayed on that corn goes directly into that meat as well. So you want to make sure that also it's not processed with any added chemicals. So another thing too is our vegetables. Try always to purchase organic. I know that it's not always a possibility, but do your best to try to do that. Come home and clean them really, really well. Like soak them in a vinegar solution to clean your vegetables, just to make sure that they're clean and ready for eating. Now, the term organic means it's different in all different parts of the world. But for the most part, it means food that's grown in a place that supports ecological balance, conserves biodiversity, and then practices cycle resources. So organic farming is not just about having things sprayed on it. Organic farming means they're really paying attention to the earth and making sure that they rotate their vegetables out so that we gain the best nutrients from those vegetables that go, as they're grown. It also restricts farmers from using fertilizers and pesticides like glyphosate or Roundup, right? And these products not only damage the vegetable, they also damage the ecosystem. They impact our water supply. And what's really interesting too, and I didn't even realize this, is that organic vegetables are at least 50% more micronutrient dense than non-organic vegetables. It's pretty interesting. And the reason for that is because of the care that farmer takes in growing them, rotating them out, different crops rotation, so that soil has time to breathe, and to get more bacterias into it. And so then so then it grows up into the vegetable. So I found that was really, really interesting. Now, what about clean eating and food quality? Clean eating removes all processed and refined foods. For many people, it's clean eating is just eating as close to the natural form as possible. So, getting your vegetables and fruits and your meats from the grocery store and cooking, using it that way. Clean can also mean that you're eating them in their raw state. So really close, as close to their original form as possible. And to illustrate this, it's like eating an orange versus the orange juice, which is, often full of added sugars too. So eating clean can provide many health benefits. Many people experience weight loss because they're eliminating the unnecessary sugars that are usually added into processed foods and refined carbohydrates. Also, like we talked about earlier, the foods are more nutrient dense, so your body is going to absorb those nutrients a lot cleaner, a lot better, because it knows what to do with them. Your body knows what to do with a fruit and a vegetable because that is how we're made. That's how we're created. So it really helps our body to function optimally when we're keeping our food as close to its original form as possible. So one example of how nutrition from whole foods can help is it can help us to avoid sickness and boost our immunity. And especially now in this climate with this pandemic that's going around, we really need to boost our immune systems. And many people are realizing that, and it's great. Many not micronutrients are crucial to the process of the immune system cells staying healthy. The immune system is designed to fight infections and diseases, and in order to do this, we need vitamin A, B6, B12, C, D, E. Folic acid is really important to make sure that we have in our diet. Iron, zinc, copper. So all of those other elements that we get from the earth. Selenium. Those are all trace elements. Those are all the things that are needed, staples that are needed in our diet. These are all really crucial for our immune system to build antibodies that fight bacteria and viruses and things that could invade our body and make us sick. And when these nutrients come from food, our bodies can utilize them right away. Another example is our hormones. Our hormones are chemical messengers responsible for a lot of different functions in our body, right? Growth, development, metabolism, reproduction, sleep, mood. And so when our food is not healthy, when we have lifestyle choices, make lifestyle choices that aren't healthy, we are creating a healthy imbalance, an unhealthy balance in our body, and our hormones suffer. And I know as a woman, I have felt that myself. But it can happen in men as well. So this type of deficiency, this micronutrient deficiency, can really wreak havoc in our on our hormones. A few tips: reduce caffeine and alcohol. Yeah, it might be a little hard at this time, because we all like to have our glass of wine to wind down at night. But just be careful. Just reduce it a little bit, just to make sure that we're not messing with our hormones too. So it's really, really important that we notice, we look at our labels, that we go towards organic when we're shopping for our fruits and vegetables. We go towards organic, grass-fed and finished beef, heritage pork, organic chicken, wild-caught fish, when we're making choices for our food, because food quality really, really does matter. It matters even more than our nutrition, because we really can't get the nutrition that our bodies need if our quality of food is not there, right? So it really does go hand in hand. So, if you're ready to make the switch to healthier eating, I have a 30-day whole body transformation happening. It's a a reset. It's based on whole foods, whole organic foods. I have an amazing group of women and men that are really taking their health and wellness to the next level. We're infusing our bodies with whole food nutrition so that our bodies can really take that nutrition and do what's necessary to make us healthier. We'll kick our cravings. What you'll also be getting is my coaching for the 30 days that you're on the reset. And I'll even help with creating your meals for you too. So what could really be easier, right? When you're getting nutrition infused in this way, our bodies can really take it in and it makes a huge difference. We're getting better sleep, we're getting more energy, skin is clearing, glowing skin. Our bodies do amazing things when we have the micronutrients that we need from our food. So message me if you'd like more information. And next week, what I'd like to talk about is really the effect of processed foods can have on our body and why we want to avoid them. And I see this happen a lot, even in the ketogenic lifestyle. And so I'm going to touch a little bit about on that too. And so I really appreciate everyone joining me today. It's been nice being with you. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your Friday and a wonderful weekend. And we will talk to you all soon. Thanks.